In this video, I'm going to show you how to use figures and tables in your paper and how to format the captions. First, I'll show you how to insert and format a table. Okay, I'm going to make a copy of this table from a research paper on facial mimicry. You can see that including the headings and the note at the bottom, we need 6 rows and 9 columns. We don't need a row for the title because we'll put that in later. Okay, let's put the table right here. So we'll put the cursor here. We'll come up to the Insert tab and we'll select the table. And you can just directly select the size, or you can come down to here and then input the size that you want. And then click OK. Next, let's enter all the headings and data. Now, don't worry about it looking ugly right now, we'll fix it later. Okay, now you can see that, especially this note down here is ridiculous and needs to be fixed. So let's do that first. Select these cells and then go to the Table Layout tab and click to merge the cells. Now you might notice that the text in the table is double spaced because our paper is double spaced, but we don't need that in a table. So let's select everything by clicking this square. And then we'll single space it. Now let's merge the labels for the dependent variable the same way we did for the note before. Okay, next let's move the borders around so that we can make all the words fit. And then we can make all of these equally spaced by clicking here. Okay, next we're going to make the note a smaller size because that doesn't need to be so important. That's probably good, 10. And then next we'll center these labels so we'll make them a little bit easier to read. Also, if you notice here, the labels for mean and standard deviation are in italics. So let's select these, come to the Home tab, and we'll turn them in italics. And finally, we need to make these lines disappear so that it looks professional. If you look at the research paper, there's only some horizontal lines. So basically, we're going to do something like that. I like to first select the whole table and then click here to make all the lines disappear. Now if we turn this off, we can't see any lines now. Now while we're working on this, let's go over here and let's click this to turn on these lines so we can kind of see what they look like. We select the row, and then on the Design tab, I just click to put a line under it. So we had one there. We put one there. Put one there, and put one there. And then once again, I can come back over here and turn off these lines so I can see what this table is going to look like when it's complete. Okay, now we insert a caption by selecting the whole table and then going to the Reference tab and clicking this. Then just check that our settings are correct, that it says table 1, we want it to be table, and we want it to be above, and then click OK. And then we just need to type the title of the table. Okay, finally, you can put a reference to the table in the text yourself by typing table 1, but you can also do it on the Reference tab by clicking here, selecting tables here, make sure you choose you only want the number and the label, and then you choose the table, and you just click that and close it, put the other parentheses. Now you'll notice the font change, so I'm going to have to let me just make everything Calibri again, and now this is automatically in there too. Okay, next we're going to insert a graph from Excel into our paper. So let's go to Excel and let's copy the graph. And then we'll come down here and make a space for it and paste it in there. Now, just like we did before, we can insert a caption by going to the References tab and clicking here. And this time we don't want a table, we want a figure. And like it, just check here that the figure should be coming below, which is what we want. And then we just need to type the caption. Okay, and then just like before, we can put a reference to our figure like that. This time we select figure, and there's only one figure. Make sure we click here to only get the label, because that's all we want. And there it is. And Word is kind of annoying this way, but we have to keep changing our font back. Okay. And then just to show you one more possibility, I'm going to also insert a picture, which I'll do right here. I'll make some space for it. And then we'll go to the Insert tab and we'll click to find a picture. And we'll locate our picture in our files and then click to insert it. Okay, and here's our picture here. And then just like before, come to the Reference tab. Let's put a thing here. This is going to be a figure again, and we want it below. That looks good. Let's click OK. And let's type our title. And then let's put a reference to it somewhere up in here. I'll just put it here. Cross-reference figure. And I want figure one. Good. Let's just put that in there. Okay. And now let's just check everything because we had another figure before that was figure one, but now that's going to have to be figure two. So we have this is figure one, this is figure one. Here's our table, table one, table one. And down here, this now says figure two. That's great. But if you look up here, now this says figure one. So what we're going to need to do is come over here and select everything in the paper. And then I usually just right click on it and come down here to update the fields. And if you click that, wait a second, then all of them will be fixed and this will be figure two now. And you're done.